that this is still the beginning. Worse or better is actually to follow. So what does 4a say? See the transparency. Observe now how much must be in the public domain. Your policy with all its activities needs to be on your website and in your director's report. Would Asian Paints in earlier years shared their list of CSR activities with Berger? Why would you disclose to your nearest competitors exactly what you are going to do, where and how? And yet now you will have to. Anyone, any one of you sitting in this room will, at the click of a button, know how much is any company of your choice, Tata Chemicals, let's say. What is their policy? What are their activities? How much have they invested in each activity? Where are they going to do this? You will be able to know. And that is the transparency which this act brings into focus. CSR is no longer that little thing you did as an afterthought. We also do CSR. No longer. You do it front on, and you do it in a way that's completely transparent and also responsible for. Now look at 4B, which goes even further. What if you make this list of activities? What if you put all your projects and programs down? What if you monitor them very closely and they still don't happen? Can you say, I listed them, I monitored them, I did my best, sorry, never happened. What can I do? I'm a human being. Is that good enough? Observe the word shall. Ensure that the activities in the policy are actually undertaken. You cannot say, well, in my policy I wrote it down, but sorry, I just couldn't undertake it. So you monitor, you undertake, you are responsible. No escape. There are no fire exits in this policy. Front on, you got to take responsibility. You got to do it. Next. That's the famous 2% clause. At one time, many in the corporate world said, hey, why are you putting this 2% thing on us? If you're really that keen, just tax us 2% and be done with it. Thankfully, that belongs to the dust heap of history. It's not your 2% that government wants. Government has enough. It is corporate social responsibility, not government social responsibility. It's what you do, your company does. It's what you put into the development agenda of this country. What you as a company who take out of society, what you put back. That's CSR. Next. The first part is for manufacturing. Of course, we know that the Indian economy has gone pretty much past manufacturing. Manufacturing is about 40% now of the total economy, 35 to 40%. Most of the rest is services. But if you have a manufacturing facility, you may want to give preference to the area around your factory or whatever. But here again, observe. You are free to do CSR anywhere in India. Kashmir to Kanyakumari, India is one. You may wish to give only preference if at all you have a manufacturing unit. If you don't, you can do it anywhere in India. But observe part two proviso, and that's the famous mandatory thing. People loosely say CSR has now become mandatory. Yes or no? Is it mandatory? Overwhelmingly, people say yes, but that's a trick question. The answer is, in fact, no. It is not mandatory. What's the principle involved here? Comply or explain. If for some reason you have not been able to spend the 2%, what do you need to do? You need to put an explanation out as to why you didn't complete the 2%. Okay? Where will that explanation go? Who will see that explanation? Will it be in a secret file, wrapped away in your cash chest? Where will this explanation go? And what could be your explanation? Had to go to a parent-teacher meeting. Got stuck in a holiday in Switzerland. Broke a few traffic rules and got nabbed by the police. What kind of explanation are you going to give? Slipped on a banana peel, broke my head. What's the explanation you're going to give here? What kind of explanation should you give? Who's going to see it? Who's going to say this explanation is good enough, not good enough? Anyone? Is that all? Ministry of Corporate Affairs, shareholders. Exactly. Your explanation, the judge will be the public. So media, activists, voluntary organizations. Of course your shareholders, stakeholders, board members, everyone, your competitors. Everybody is going to see that explanation, and you will need to defend that explanation. So anything that's frivolous is not likely to pass public scrutiny. So when you give your explanation, it has to be such that the public will accept it. The wider public domain. Better, therefore, to spend the 2% rather than damage the reputation of the company. However, if you wish to do so, you may give any explanation which your board may approve, but that really is your choice. Next. 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 Many people ask, suppose I, as a company, are really thick-skinned. I have the skin of a rhinoceros. So I decide I will not do CSR. It's rubbish anyway. Some idiot in Shastri Bhavan wrote some ruck and they pushed it down for the entire corporate world. I denounce CSR because it is trash. And you are entitled to hold that opinion. You may feel that in the corporate world, the bottom line, the profit is all that matters. I am a manufacturer of waste paper baskets. I develop wastewater pipes. What on earth should I be bothered about CSR? I manufacture spectacle frames. Why should I get into CSR? I don't even want it. It's crap, it's rubbish. I want to make money, as much of it as I can, and that's my business motto. So I will never ever do CSR. My board agrees with me. To hell with you. So far, okay. That's your opinion. And it's acceptable. You can even write that as an explanation as to why you don't do CSR. You can, technically. But what if you say that I will not do CSR and I will not also explain anything? Who the hell is anyone to ask for an explanation? It's rubbish. I don't want to do CSR. It's my belief. Why should I explain anything? I am the person who has spent money in putting up my business. I employ 40-50 people. I do great work for the country. That's my CSR. Why should I do all this crap? It's rubbish. And that's my explanation. I will neither explain nor do CSR. Then what? And many people ask this question. Why have you passed an act which means nothing? Does it mean anything or not? If you neither do CSR nor provide an explanation, then this is what happens to you. Next. Now, you might ask, this wretched government has imposed CSR on the corporate world. Okay, bad enough. But if government says do CSR, government is also duty bound to tell you what the hell does government mean by CSR. Look, every one of you sitting in this room will have a different definition of CSR. But here, who's asking you to do CSR? Government. So you have a right to ask government, what the very hell do you mean by CSR? You better come clean. And so government has. In Schedule 7 of this Act, there are 11 items, one of which is missing in my slides, with which I will tell you. These are the only 11 areas in which you can do CSR, none other. You can have your own personal wish list for as long as you want, but this is all you can do under the Act and the rules now. Next slide. These are the first 10, the budget presented by our Finance Minister, Mr. Jaitley, has added one more, slum development. That is 11. And that will come out in my next updated slide and in my next updated book. There's a little booklet, by the way, I don't know if you've seen it, it's called CSR Ready Reckoner. Please take it out because I will now ask you to refer to it. It's a green book and I just hold up your book for everyone. This is the book. Please have it in front of you. This is the Bible. This is all you need. It has everything on CSR up to yesterday midnight except slum development. The Act, the Section 135, I'm taking you through the rules framed thereunder, 27 February 2014, and the clarifications that the Ministry has issued subsequently, all of it in one handy booklet. Please refer to it as often as you want to. Next, please. So if all this is happening, what's the totality? What's the national picture like? How many companies, how much money, who's to do what, how to do it. That's more or less the national picture. By CPUs, we mean central public sector undertakings. SLPEs represent the state level public enterprises, who, by the way, do constitute actually present a fair amount, 263 crores. Most of the state public sector undertakings are pretty much perpetually sick. But there are some good ones like the Odisha Mining Corporation, which is highly profitable. Alright, next. So then, let's think. We are sitting in the board of a company, one of those 16,000, which are supposed to do CSR, all right? We are its board members and we are required to do CSR. Let's say that, for argument's sake, we have a budget of 10 crores of rupees and we want to spend it, all right? What would you, as a member of that committee, what would be your strategy to undertake CSR? Presuming for a minute, one, that you have never done CSR before, or if you have done it, you've done it only off and on. If that is the company, that is your background, how would you go about actually making out a strategy for CSR? Anyone can give me a couple of points? What would you immediately do? Yes, sir.
First, identifying the issues that the company is trying to take.
So, to begin with, what are the areas in that Schedule 7 that you as a company feel you should work in? So it could be education, it could be health, it could be more than one. It doesn't have to be just one. Okay, that's a great start. You start off with which subject, which area, which sector would you like to work in? Very nice. What's next?
Joining hands with an NGO that is dealing with...
Correct. This rule tells you that the company by itself is not expected to do the CSR activity. The company executives are not supposed to do CSR. They can if they want to voluntarily, but the Act or the rules do not expect that a company which is producing LED bulbs and the human resources which it has to develop LED bulbs doesn't have to do CSR.